What's good culture? It's your boy Franco, and this Lil Tum just literally lost all credibility inside of hip-hop. Now usually I don't curse like that on my channel, but what the f***? Not only did you go ahead and do a song with this man, I gave him the benefit of doubt on my other video about this whole situation, but you got caught in 4k with this while making the song, and then you go on a little rampage denying the whole situation. You can deny everything you do, but that video was in 4k, man. And like, this is just, I can't even really wrap my mind around this, y'all. Like, this does, I still hasn't even really registered with me yet. Take a look at this, y'all. Bro, if y'all didn't think that was bad enough, there's more. Yes, there's more. Like, they literally got evidence on top of evidence to prove that this was making music with them. So I'm still lost for words, y'all. This doesn't make any sense in my mind. It still hasn't fully registered yet. The video is still like in my mind, but it hasn't fully registered yet. Here we have 6ix9ine, a certified rat snitch inside of our hip-hop culture. Mind you, he's still walking and breathing. Nothing has happened to him. And we have the killer of King Von, probably two of the most hated individuals inside of the hip-hop space. Currently, they go ahead and do a song together, but Lil Tum has street credibility. He's backed by NBA YoungBoy, Quan Orano, and the whole association with that crew. But he goes ahead and does a song, the most villainous evil figure inside of the space besides Lil Tum and Quan Orano. And not only did this man go ahead and do a song with them, this man got out the Uber with this man. So these dudes are like buddy buddy, talking in the car, like everything. It was more than just a song for what it looks like. It was like these were butt buddies in the clip. But in Lil Tum's defense, he's saying that the only reason he did the song, which he actually even do the song, he said the only reason he was there is so he could finesse 6ix9ine out of the feature, in which 6ix9ine was gonna cash app him the money for the feature. But Lil Tum actually didn't do anything on the feature, and if what he's saying makes sense, it will correlate with why 6ix9ine gave the video clips to academics, because the only way this will be released is someone at that place getting the clips from that area and sending it to academics. And I honestly think 6ix9ine got burned because he probably sent the money to Lil Tum for the feature, but he found out Lil Tum finessed them out of the feature, and he said, fuck it, I'ma expose this little nigga. And that's how he got the clips. This just really exposed the music industry and just exposed some of y'all favorite rappers for what it really is: entertainment. And I'm pretty sure Quan Orano, Lil Tum had some fans backing him in this situation, but since he went ahead and got exposed in 4k doing a song with this nigga 6ix9ine, they're pretty much gonna give the middle finger to Quan Orano and Lil Tum. Fuck y'all niggas, y'all some snitches because y'all associate with them. It's simple as that, man. There is no rap career for Lil Tum after this. And matter of fact, NBA YoungBoy's career is actually gonna suffer as a result of this. NBA YoungBoy has to kick these niggas out expeditiously or not associate with them anymore, because his name and likeness is tied to this, and that is unfortunate for him because he has nothing to do with it. But it's the reality of the situation. Pick your crewmates wisely, because Lil Tum chose the money. I don't think he chose the clout. He don't want anyone to know about this, but he chose the money over his friend's image and the fans that were bagging him, because he knows damn well his fans would not want him to do something like this, if he even has fans anymore, to be honest. Bruh, he's out of here, coach. That's all I really gotta say about this situation. How you fall off before you even get on, man? Usually I don't like going super hard on rappers, but really, how you fall on before you get on, cuz? Like, you ain't even drop an album yet, and you already got the fans of perception on you to be in the gutter, man. And it's unfortunate because 6ix9ine finessed you for the song, and when you actually thought you were finessing him. So you basically, y'all both got finessed. And the thing is, you actually hurting the people around you more than you're hurting 6ix9ine, because Quan Orano's image, already tainted, already blackballed as is gonna take a hit even further. Not to even mention NBA YoungBoy, like I touched on earlier. Now Quan Orano is gonna get extra hate, extra blackballed, extra attempts at his life, unfortunately, because of the result of your actions. Because Quan Arano makes it abundantly clear that you and him are close, with him buying you jewelry after the King Von situation and continuously shining you up because y'all are like this in the fans' perspective on social media. It's rats, man. It's pretty much it. That's all I gotta say about this situation. Your boy Frank Lazar. This is what happens in the hip-hop music industry, y'all. This is all, it's all entertainment, bro.